Oh, it's come to this, hasn't it? Well, I'm going to be reading the entire B-movie script because life has its moments, doesn't it? Has those little moments that we all know and love, and this is one of those. Actually, this is pain. This is 100% pure pain. I'm just going to get right into it. The B-movie script. According to all the laws of aviation, there is no way a bee should be able to fly. Its wings are too fat to get its fat little body off the ground. The bee, of course, flies anyway, because bees don't care what humans think is impossible. Yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black. Oh, black and yellow. Let's shake it up a little. Barry, breakfast is ready. I assume there's a typo in the script procedure. Also, I haven't seen this movie since its release. I remember my grandparents were renting it from Movie Gallery, and I watched it, and I was kind of like, that's the guy from Seinfeld. That's the guy from Seinfeld. He's a bee. Was I in high school at that point? I don't even know how old B movie is. It's been a while. It's been a while. I'll get back to the script now. Hang on. My girlfriend's reaction to my pun was a lot better than my reaction to it. I'm very sad you didn't all get to hear it. That's your face. Hang on a second. Oh, Barry, Adam, can you believe this is happening? I can't. I'll pick you up. Look at sharp. Use those stairs. Your father paid good money for those. Sorry, I'm excited. I'm assuming, you know, I like how the entire of the script doesn't have which character they're speaking, so I just have to guess which one is Seinfeld and which one is everyone else. Sorry, I'm excited. Here's the graduate. We're very proud of you, son. A perfect report card. All B's. Very proud. Ma, I got a thing going on here. You got lint on your fuzz. Oh, that's me. Wave to us. We'll be in row 118,000. Bye. Barry, I told you, stop flying in the house. Hey, Adam. Hey, Barry. Is that fuzz gel?
Is that fun? I don't know who's speaking. A little.
Special ed graduation. Never thought I'd make it. 3 days grade school, 3 days high school. Those were awkward. 3 days college. I'm glad it took a day to get you out alive. You did come back different. Hi, Barry. Marty, growing a mustache. What's good? Hear about Frankie? Yeah. You going to the funeral? No, I'm not going. Everybody knows, sting someone, you die. Don't waste it on a squirrel. Such a hothead. I guess he could have just gotten out of the way.
Someone knows I'm already fucking dead. Somebody's already dead in this movie at this point. They're just referencing that he's fucking dead. And nobody shed a fucking tear. Are they going to have a funeral at the graduation?
I love this incorporating an amusement park into our day. That's why I don't need vacations. Boy, might have a bit of a pump under the circumstances. Well, Adam, today we are men. We are. Be men. Hallelujah. Sons, faculty, distinguished bees, please welcome Dean Boswell.
Welcome, New High City, graduating class of 915. This concludes our ceremonies and begins your career at HunX Industries. It's the fucking beehive. Look at the fucking bees, guys. We are fucking bees. Did anybody else realize that we're fucking bees? Because I am a fucking bee. Will we pick up our job today? I heard it's just orientation. Heads up, here we go. Keep your hands and antennas inside the tram at all times. Wonder what it'll be like. A little scary. Welcome to HunX, a division of HunXco, and part of the Hexagon Group. Oh, Mitchell. This is it. Wow. We know that you, as a bee, have worked your whole life to get to the point where you can work for your whole life. Honey begins when our valiant pollen jocks bring the nectar to the hive. Our top secret formula is sugar, honeycomb, bee cum, and just a little bit of elbow grease. Makes honey just really good, delicious. Our top secret formula is automatically color corrected, scent adjusted, and bubble contoured into this soothing sweet syrup with its distinctive golden glow you know as honey.
That girl's hot! She's my cousin! She is! Yes, we're all cousins! Right, you're right! And HunX, we constantly strive to improve our aspect of bee existence. These bees are stress testing a new helmet technology. What do you think he makes? Not enough! Here we have our latest advancement,
The gremlin! What does that do? Cashes that little strata of money and hangs it after you pour it. Saves us millions! Can anyone work on the gremlin? Of course! Well, bee job, most bee jobs are small ones.
Most bee jobs are small ones. But bees know that every small job, if it's done well, means a lot. But choose carefully, because you'll stay in the job you pick for the rest of your life. I did CEO. Did I win the $1 million prize?
The same job for the rest of your life? I didn't know that. What's the difference? You'll be happy to know the bees as a species have had one day off in 27 million years. Sounds work us to death? We'll soon try. Wow, that blew my mind. What's the difference? How can you say that? One job forever? That's an insane choice to make.
Honey, our son's gonna be one of those weird bee artists, isn't he? One of those weird philandering men hanging around on fountains, drawing caricatures for old people. I mean, Jesus Christ. Or the...
I'm relieved. Now we only have to wait and make one decision in life. But how could they have never told us that? Why would you question anything? We're bees! We're the most perfectly functioning society on Earth. You ever think maybe things work a little too well down here? Like what? Give me one example. I don't know, but you know what I'm talking about. Please, clear the gate.
Royal Nectar Force on approach. I want to be a fucking bee guard, my man. I want to be a fucking bee royal guard. That'd be sweet as shit. Wait a second. Check it out.
Hey, those are pollen dogs. Wow, I've never seen them this close.
So I'll stop there, Jerry Seinfeld, for now.
They know what it's like outside the hive.
Yeah, but some don't come back.
Hey, Jax.
Hi, Jax.
You guys did great. You're monsters, and you're sky freaks. And I love it. I love it.
I wonder where they were.
I don't know.
Their day's not planned. Outside the hive, flying who knows where, doing who knows what. You can't just decide to be a pollen jock. You have to be bred for that.
Right. Look. That's more pollen than you and I will ever see in a lifetime.
It's just a status symbol. Bees make too much of it. Perhaps, unless you're wearing it and the ladies see you wearing it. Those ladies, aren't they our cousins too?
Distant. Distant. Hey, aren't those fucking, let's fuck some of those bee girls over there. You know those bee girls over there? Let's go fuck them. Let's just go and take their little stingers and put them in their stingers and then make their stingers and burn it. They'll probably die, but it'll be great. It'll be a nice romp. It'll be gangbang, if you will. Look at these two.
Couple of hive harries.
Let's have fun with them. Must be dangerous being a pollen jock.
Yeah, once a bit, pin me against a mushroom. He had a paw on my throat, and with the other, he was slapping me. Oh my! I never thought I'd knock him out!
Why is it fucking knocking a bear out? A bear? Are you fucking serious, Mr. B? You can't do shit. You're just all talk, motherfucker. Where was I?
Oh my!
I never thought I'd knock him out. What are you doing during this? Trying to alert the authorities. I can autograph that. A little gutsy out there today, wasn't it, comrades?
Yeah, gutsy. Running a sunflower patch 6 miles from here tomorrow. 6 miles, huh? Barry, a puddle jump for us. But maybe you're not up for it.
Maybe I am.
You are not. We're going at 0900 at J-Gang. What do you think, Buzzy Boy? Are you B enough?
This is one thing that I always have problems with in shows or movies where the characters refer to each other as bees. I'm surprised they haven't said every buzzy or every beery. I'm sickly. If you can say bye, you can say people. I mean, it's a kitsch cartoon show. You don't have to be very... They're sentient bees, for Christ's sake. They don't have to be... I'm just done. It might be. It all depends on what 0900 means.
Hey, Onyx. Dad, you surprised me.
You decide what you're interested in? Well, there's a lot of choices, but you only get one.
Do you get bored doing the same job every day?
Son, let me tell you about stirring. You grab that stick, you just move it around, and you stir it around. You get yourself into a rhythm. It's a beautiful thing.
The more I think about it, maybe the honey field just isn't right for me.
You were thinking of what? Making balloon animals? That's a bad job for a guy with a stinger. Ba-dum-bum.
Janet, your son's not sure he wants to go into honey.
Barry, you're so funny sometimes.
I'm not trying to be funny.
You're not funny. You're going into honey. You're not funny. You're going into honey. It is a musical. Our son, the stirrer. You're going to be a stirrer?
No one's listening to me.
Wait till you see the sticks I have.
I can see anything right now. I'm going to get Nan tattoo. Let's open up some money and celebrate. Maybe I'll pierce my thorax.
Stand by antenna! Stand up in the grasshopper! Get a gold tooth and call everyone dog!
This is Jerry Seinfeld's like, what are the kids like today?
They like it when people say dog, right? They like it when they're like, hey, no dog, right? I just read that in my joke notebook from 1992. I just want to make sure that I'm current.
I actually do like Ian Connor's getting coffee with celebrities or comedians. That's a really good show, actually. Some of the episodes are fucking phenomenal, but B-Movie was just kind of a blur. I remember that the B-Movie wanted to fuck the human lady, and that's about it.
I'm so proud. We're starting work today. Today's the days. Come on, all the good jobs will be gone. Yeah, right. Pollen counting, stump bee, porting stir, front desk, hair removal. Is it still available? Hang on, two left. One of them's yours. Congratulations. Step to the side. What did you get? Pick and crud out. Stellar. Wow. Couple of newbies? Yes, sir. Our first day. We are ready. Make a choice. You want to go first? No, you go. Oh my, what's available? Restroom attendance open? Not for the reason you think. Any chance of getting the Krellman? Sure, you're on. I'm sorry, the Krellman just closed out. Wax Lucky's always open. The Krellman opened up again. What happened? A bee died. Mason opening. See? He's dead. Another dead one. Dead bee. Deadified. Two more dead. Dead from the neck up. Dead from the neck down. That's life. Oh, this is so hard. Heating, cooling, stumpy, porous, stir, humming, inspection number 7, lint coordinator, stripe supervisor, Mike Wrangler, Barry. What do you think I should do? Barry. All right, we got the Sunflower Magic Quadrant 9. What happened to you? Where are you?
I'm going out.
Out? Out where?
Out there.
Oh, no.
I have to, before I go, to work for the rest of my life.
You're going to die. You're crazy. Hello? Another call coming in. If anyone's feeling brave, there's a Korean deli on 83rd that gets their roses today. Hey, guys. Look at that. Isn't that the kid we saw yesterday? Hold it, son. Flight deck's restricted. It's okay, Lou. We're going to take him up. Really? Feeling lucky, are you? Sign here. Here. Just initial that.
Thank you.
Okay. You got a rain advisory today. As you all know, bees cannot fly in the rain. So be careful. As always, watch your brooms, honey sticks, hockey sticks, dogs, birds, bears, and bats. Also, got a couple of reports of root beer being poured on us. Murphy's in a home because of it. Battling like a cicada. That's awful. And a reminder for you rookies. Bee law number 1. Absolutely no talking to humans. If they find out the bees talk, they're going to flip their shit and they're going to be on every news channel. And maybe they'll try to save the extinct. Almost, you know, the dwindling bee population after they find out bees fucking talk. If bees actually talk, maybe people would actually give a shit about the bees before they go extinct and all of us die because the food chain will be upset. Save the bees. Save the bees. All right, launch positions. Buzz, 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 buzz. Buzz, 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 buzz. Black and yellow. Hello. You. How many times? I'm assuming, Charlie, have you seen the movie?
No.
Okay, I'm assuming Black and Yellow has played this movie. I almost faintly remember it. That's gotta be a song that's in this movie. It's almost ridiculous if it's not in the movie. You ready for this hot shot?
Yeah, bring it on.
Wind check, antenna check, nectar pack check, wings check, stinger check, scared out of my shorts check. Okay, ladies, let's move it out. Pound those petunias, you striped stem suckers. Pound those petunias, you striped stem suckers. All of you, bring those flowers.
Wow, I'm out. I can't believe I'm out. So blue. I feel so fast and free. Box cutting. Wow, flowers.
This is Blue Leader. We have roses. Visual. Bring it around 30 degrees to hold. Roses, 30 degrees. Roger. Bringing it around. Stand to the side, kid. It's got a bit of a kick. That is one nectar collector. Ever seen pollination up close?
No, sir.
I pick up some pollen here, sprinkle it over here, maybe a dash over there, a pinch on that. Let's see that. It's a little bit of magic.
That's amazing. Why don't we do that?
That's pollen power. More pollen, more flowers, more nectar, more honey for us.
Oh!
I'm picking up a lot of bright yellow. Could be daisies. Don't we need those? Copy that visual. Wait, one of these flowers seems to be on the move.
Say it again. You're reporting a moving flower?
Affirmative. That was on the line.
This is the coolest. What is it?
I don't know, but I'm loving this color.
It smells good. Not like a flower, but I like it.
Yeah, fuzzy, chemically. Careful, guys, it's a little grabby.
My sweet lord of bees!
Candy brain, get off there. Problems? Guys, this could be bad. Affirmative, very close. Get hurt, mom's little boy. You're way out of position, rookie. Coming at you like a missile.
Help me!
I don't think these are flowers. Should we tell him? I think he knows.
What is this?
Match point. You can start by packing up, honey, because you're about to eat it.
Yowzer!
Gross. There's a bee in the car. Do something. I'm driving.
Hi, bee.
He's back there.
He's going to sting me.
Nobody move. If you don't move, he won't sting you.
Freeze. He blinked. Spray him, Granny. What are you doing?
Wow. The tension level out here is unbelievable. I gotta get home. Can't fly in the rain. Can't fly in the rain. Can't fly in the rain.
Mayday.
Mayday, be going down. Ken, could you close the window, please? Ken, could you close the window, please?
Check out my new resume. I made it into a full-out brochure. You see? Folds out.
Oh, no. Oh, humans. I don't need this. What was that? Maybe this stripes.
That is diabolical. It's fantastic. It's got all my special moves. You, my top 10 favorite movies. What's number one? Star Wars. Nah, I don't go for that kind of stuff.
No wonder we shouldn't talk to them. They're out of their minds.
I agree with that fucking bee. Who the fuck doesn't like Star Wars? Who doesn't like Star Wars, no fuckers? Who doesn't like Star Wars? Goddamn, fucking Star Wars is great. No wonder we shouldn't talk to them. They're out of their minds. But I leave a job interview, they're flabbergasted. Can't believe what I say. There's a sun.
Maybe that's the way out. I don't remember the sun having a big 75 on it.
I predicted global warming. I can feel it getting hotter. At first, I thought it was just me. Wait, stop. B. Stand back. These are winter boots. Wait, don't kill them. You know I'm allergic to them. This thing could kill me. Why does his life have less value than yours? Why does his life have any value, but any less value than mine? Is that your statement? I'm just saying a life has value. You don't know what he's capable of feeling. I mean, come on. We can't kill bugs. If you see a bug on the ground, walk around it. Don't just step on it like some kind of big faggot. That's evil. That's diabolical. Don't be a bitch about it. My brochure. There you go, little guy. I'm not scared of him. It's an allergic thing. I am absolutely terrified of bees because I don't carry around an EpiPen because I'm an idiot and I'm definitely allergic to them. Why do you think I don't go outside? Why do you think I'm a pasty white nerd? I'm fucking scared of bees. They're the worst thing ever. If I see a bee, I'm bolting my shit. I don't give a damn if I look like a little ass girl. This man is completely justified to be terrified of a fucking little death monster. I understand. I understand if I leave him alone, he'll leave me alone. But I don't trust him. I don't trust bees. Fuck bees. Put that on your resume brochure. The whole face can puff up. Maybe one of your special skills. Knocking someone out is also a special skill, right? Bye, Vanessa. Thanks. Vanessa, next week, you know, good night. Sure can, you know, whatever. You put some carrot chips on there. Bye. It's supposed to be less calories. Bye. I gotta say something. She saved my life. I gotta say something. All right. Here it goes. What would I say? I can really get in trouble. It's me, law. You're not supposed to talk to a human. I can't believe I'm doing this. I can't do it. Come on. No. Yes. No. Do it. I can't. How should I start it? You're like, yes. No, that's no good. Here she comes. Speak, you fool. What's the deal with you? That'd be the first thing that comes out of his mouth.
Hi. I'm sorry. You're talking. Yeah, I know. You're talking. I'm sorry. No, it's okay. I'm fine. I'm dreaming. I don't recall going to bed. Actually, that's very disconcerting. But it's a surprise to me. I mean, you're a bee. I am. I'm not supposed to be doing this. But they were trying to kill me. And it wasn't for you. I didn't thank you. It's just how I was raised. That was a little weird. Talking with a bee. Yeah. I'm talking to a bee. And the bee's talking to me. I just want to say I'm grateful. I'll leave you out. Wait. How did you want to do that? What? The talking thing. Same way you did, I guess. Mama, daddy, honey, you pick it up.
That's very funny.
Yeah, bees are funny. Bees are funny. If we didn't laugh, we'd cry with what we have to deal with. Anyway, can I?
Yeah, anyway, can I get you something?
Like what?
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Coffee?
I don't want to put you out. It's no trouble.
It takes 2 minutes. It's coffee.
I hate to impose.
Don't be ridiculous.
Actually, a little cup. Hey, you want rum cake?
I shouldn't. Have some. No, I can't. Come on. No, I literally can't. I'm a bee. You can't feed bees cake. They don't. I mean, actually, I don't know. Can you feed a bee cake? That's a quandary. It's a moral quandary. Could you feed a bee cake? That's interesting. I'm trying to lose a couple micrograms.
Where? These stripes don't help. You look great. I don't know if you should know anything about fashion.
Are you all right? No, he's making the tie in the cab as they're flying up Madison. Finally gets there. He runs up the steps of the church the wedding's on. He says, watermelon. I thought you said Guatemalan. Why would I marry a watermelon? Is that a bee joke? That's the kind of stuff we do. Yeah, different.
So what are you going to do, Barry?
Am I going to work? I don't know. I want to do my part for the hive, but I can't do it the way they want.
I know how you feel.
You do? Sure. My parents wanted to be a lawyer or a doctor, but I wanted to be a florist.
Really?
My only interest is flowers.
Our new queen was just elected with that same campaign slogan. Have my only interest is flowers. Okay, that was a little goofy. That was a clever setup and a clever joke, and I enjoyed it even though it was a B joke. Anyway, if you look, there's my hive right there. See it?
You're in Sheep Meadow. Yeah, right off Turtle Pond. No way, I know that area. I lost a toe ring there once. A lot of girls put rings in their toes. Why not? It's like putting a hat on your knee. Maybe I'll try that. You all right, ma'am? Oh, yeah, fine. Just having two cups of coffee. Anyway, this has been great. Thanks for the coffee. Yeah, it's no trouble. Sorry I couldn't finish it. If I did, it'd be up the rest of my life. Are you... Can I take a piece of this with me? Oh, sure, yeah. Here, have a crumb. Thanks. Yeah. All right, well, then, I guess I'll see you around. Or not. Okay, Mary. Thank you so much, Ian, for before. Oh, that was nothing. Well, not nothing, but anyway, this can't possibly work. He's all set to go. We may as well try it. Okay, Dave. Pull the chute. Sounds amazing. It was amazing. It was the scariest, happiest moment of my life. Humans. I can't believe you were with humans. Giant, scary humans. What were they like? Huge and crazy. They talk crazy. They eat giant, crazy, giant things, and they drive crazy. Did some of them try to kill you? Like on TV? TV is there, not TV, but you know, it's in my head. Some of them don't. How'd you get back? Poodle, you did it. And I'm glad you saw whatever you wanted to see. You had your experience, now you can pick out your job and be normal. Well, I met someone.
You did?
Was she beatish? A wasp? Your parents will kill you. No, not a wasp. Spider? I'm not attracted to spiders. I know it's the hottest thing with the eight legs and all. How would a bee fuck a spider? It would eat the shit out of a bee. The insect relationships in this movie are just completely throwing me out of balance. This is how furries are made. And so Zootopia in this movie is what created an entire generation of furries. These babies are going to be walking, talking yivers. I can't get by that face. So who is she? She's a human. No, that's Beelaw. You wouldn't break a Beelaw. Her name's Vanessa. Oh boy, she's so nice. And she's a florist. Oh no, you're dating a human florist. We're not dating. You're flying outside the hive, talking to humans that suck our homes with power washers and M80s. 1/8 a stick of dynamite. She saved my life and she understands me. This is over. Eat this. This is not over. What is that? They call it crumb. It's so stinking stripy. That's not what they eat. That's what falls off of what they eat. You know what a Cinnabon is? No. It's bread and cinnamon frosting. They heat it up, sit down really hot. Listen to me. We're not them. We're us. There's us and there's them. Yeah, but who can deny that the heart is yearning? There's no yearning. Stop yearning. Listen to me. You've got to start thinking B, my friend. Thinking B. Thinking B. Thinking B. Thinking B. Thinking B. Thinking B. There he is. He's in the pool. No, your problem is Barry. I got to start thinking B. How much longer will this go on? It's been 3 days. When are you working? I got a lot of big life decisions to think about. What life? You have no life. You have no job. You're barely a bee. Would it kill you to make a little humming? Humming? Honey? Barry, come out. Your father's talking to you. Martin, what'd you talk to him? Barry, I'm talking to you. You coming? Got everything all set? Go ahead. I'll catch up. Don't be too long. Watch this. Vanessa, we're still here. I told you not to yell at him. He doesn't respond to yelling. Why yell at me? Because you didn't listen. I'm not listening to this. Sorry, I gotta go. Where are you going? I mean a friend, a girl. Is this why you can't decide? Bye. I hope she's beatish. They have a huge parade of flowers every year in Pasadena to be in the torment of the roses. That's every florist's dream. Up on the floor, surrounded by flowers, crowds are cheering. A tournament. Do the roses compete in athletic events? No. All right. I got one. How come you don't fly everywhere? It's exhausting. Why don't you run everywhere? It's faster. Okay. Yeah. All right. I see. All right. Your turn. TiVo. You just freeze live TV? That's insane. You don't have that? We have HIVO. That's a disease. It's a horrible, horrible disease. Oh my. Dumb bees. You must want to sting all those jerks. We try not to sting. It's usually fatal for us. So you have to watch your temper. Very carefully. You kick a wall, tape a walk, write an angry letter and throw it out. Work through it like any emotion. Anger, jealousy, lust. Oh my goodness, are you okay? Yeah. What's wrong with you? It's a bug. He's not bothering anybody. Get out of here, you creep. What was that? A pick and save circular? Yeah, it was. How'd you know? Felt like about 10 pages. 75 is pretty much our limit. You've got to do that down to a science. I lost a cousin to Italian Vogue. I'll bet. What in the name of Mighty Hercules was this? How did this get out here? Out B, Golden Blossom, Ray Liotta Prize Select. Is he that actor? I never heard of him. Why is this here? For people. We eat it. You don't have enough food of your own? Well, yes. How do you get it? Bees make it. I know who makes it. It's hard to make. There's heating, cooling, stirring. You need a whole Kremlin thing. It's organic. It's our organic.
It's just honey, Barry. Just what? Bees don't know about this. This is stealing. A lot of stealing. We've taken our homes, schools, hospitals. It's all we have. And it's on sale. I'm getting to the bottom of this. I'm getting to the bottom of all of this. Hey, Hector. You almost done? Almost. He's here. I sense it. Well, I guess I'll go home now and just leave this nice honey out with no one around. You're busted, box boy. I knew I heard something, so you can't talk. I can't talk. And now you'll start talking. Where do you get the sweet stuff? Who's your supplier? I don't understand. I thought we were friends. The last thing we wanted to do is upset bees. You surely, it's ours now. Sir, I've crossed the wrong sword. You, sir, will be lunch from an iguana in Benicio. Where's the honey coming from? Tell me where. Honey farms. It comes from honey farms. Crazy person. What horrible thing has happened here? These faces. They never knew what hit them, and now they're on the road to nowhere. Just keep still. What? You're not dead. Do I look dead? Don't let anything that moves. Where are you headed? Honey farms. I'm on a something huge there. I'm going to Alaska. Moose blood. Crazy stuff. Blows your head off. I'm going to Tacoma. Hey, Tacoma. Hey, you? He really is dead. All right. What's that? Oh, no. A wiper. Triple blade. Jump on. It's your only chance, B. Why does everything have to be so doggone clean? How much do you people need to see? Open your eyes. Stick your head out the window. From NPR News in Washington, I'm Carl Kessel. But don't kill no more bugs. B. Moose blood guy. You hear something? Like what? My tiny screaming. Turn off the radio. What's up, B-boy? Hey, blood. Just throw a honey drop as far as the eye can see. Wow. I assume wherever this truck goes is where they're getting it. I mean, the honey's ours. Bees hang tight. We're all jammed in. It's a close community. Not us, man. We got our own. Every mosquito on his own. What if you get in trouble? You a mosquito, you in trouble. Nobody likes us. They just smack. See a mosquito. Smack. Smack. At least you're out in this world. You must be girls. Mosquito girls try to trade up, get with a moth. Dragonfly. Mosquito girl don't want no mosquito. Oh, is the mosquito like the token black character? Is that what it is? You gotta be kidding me. Moose Blood's about to leave the building. So long, B. Hey, guys. Moose Blood. I knew I'd catch y'all down here. You bring your crazy straw, you throw it in a jar, slap a label on it. It's pretty much pure profit. What is this place? B's got a brain the size of a pinhead. They are pinheads. Pinhead. Check out the new smoker. Oh, sweet. That's the one you want. The Thomas 3000. Smoker. 90 puffs a minute. Semi-automatic. Twice the nicotine. All the tar. Couple of breaths of this knocks them right out. They kill the bees by making them vape. That's how they kill the bees. They make the bees vape, and the bees just kind of, society just kind of collapses on itself due to vape culture. Ah, vape nation. Couple of breaths of this knocks them right out. They make the honey, we make the money. They make the honey, and we make the money. Oh my, what's going on? Are you okay? Yeah, it doesn't last too long. Do you know you're in a fake hive with fake walls? Our queen moved here. We have no choice. This is your queen? It's a man in woman's clothes. That's a drag queen. What is this? Oh no, there's hundreds of them. Bee honey. Our honey is being brazenly stolen on a massive scale. This is worse than anything bears have done. I intend to do something. Oh, Barry, stop. Who told you humans are taking our honey? That's a rumor. Do these look like rumors? That's a conspiracy theory. These are obviously doctored photos. How'd you get mixed up in this? He's been talking to humans. What? Talking to humans? Yeah, but he's a human girlfriend. And they make out. Make out. Barry, we do not. You wish you could. Whose side are you on? The bees. I dated a cricket in San Antonio. Those crazy legs kept me up all night. Barry, this is what you want to do with your life. I want to do it all for all our lives. Nobody works harder than bees. Dad, I remember you coming home so overworked. Your hands were still stirring. You couldn't stop. I remember that. What right do they have to our honey? We live on 2 cups a year. They put it in lip balm for no reason whatsoever. Even if it's true, what can one bee do? Sting them really where it hurts. In the face. In the eye. Now it hurt. No. Out the nose. That's a killer. There's only one place you can sting humans. Or one place where it matters. Hive 5. The hive's only full-hour action news source. No more bee beards with Bob Bungle at the anchor desk. Whether with Storm Stinger, sports with Buzz Larvae, and Jeanette Chung. Good evening, I'm Bob Bundle, and I'm Jeanette Chung. Tri-County bee Barry Benson intends to sue the human race for stealing our honey, packaging it, and profiting from it illegally. Oh, I forgot that the Plymouth boy was suing humanity because we eat honey. Tomorrow night on Bee Larry Kane, we'll have the three former queens here in our studio discussing their new book, Classy Ladies, out this week on Hexagon. Tonight we're talking to Barry Benson. Did you ever think, I'm a kid from the hive, I can't do this? Bees have never been afraid to change the world. What about Bee Columbus? Bee Gandhi? Bejesus? Where I'm from, we'd never sue humans. We're thinking of stickball or candy stores. How old are you? The bee community is supporting you in this case, which would be the trial of the bee century, which is about a week. You know they have a Larry King of the human world too. It's a common name, next week. He looks like you and has a show in suspenders and colored dots. Next week, glasses, quotes in the bottom from the guest, even though you just heard him. Bear week next week. They're scary, hairy, and here live. Here, always leaning forward, pointy shoulders, squinty eyes, very Jewish. And tennis, you attack at the point of weakness. As my grandmother can, she's 81. Honey, her backhand's a joke. I'm not going to take advantage of that. Quiet, please. Actual work going on here. Is that the same bee? Yes, it is. I'm helping him sue the human race. Hello, bee. This is Ken. Yeah, I remember you, Timblin, size 10 and a half. Vibrant soul, I believe. Why does he talk again? Listen, you better go, because we're really busy working. But it's our yogurt night. Bye. Why is yogurt night so difficult? You poor thing. You two have been here for hours. Yes, and Adam here has been a huge help. Frosting. How many sugars? Just one. I try not to use the competition. So why are you helping me? These have good qualities and it takes my mind off the shop. Instead of flowers, people are getting balloon bouquets now. Those are great if you're three. And artificial flowers. Oh, those can be just psychotic. Yeah, me too. Bed stickers, pointless pollination. Bees must hate those fake things. Nothing worse than a daffodil that's had work done. Maybe this could make up for it a little bit. This lawsuit's a pretty big deal, I guess. You sure you want to go through with it? Am I sure? When I'm done with the humans, they won't be able to say, honey, I'm home without paying the royalty. It's an incredible scene here in downtown Manhattan, where the world anxiously awaits because for the first time in history, we will hear for ourselves if a honeybee can actually speak. What have we gone into here, Barry? It's pretty big, isn't it? I can't believe how many humans don't work during the day. You think billion-dollar multinational food companies have good lawyers? Everybody needs to stay behind a barricade. What's the matter? I don't know, I just gotta chill. Well, if it isn't the bee team, you boys working on this, I'll rise. The Honorable Judge Bumbleton presiding. All right, case number 4475, Superior Court of New York, Barry B. Benson versus the honey industry, is now in session. Mr. Montgomery, you're representing the five food companies collectively, the random gray faceless food companies, not any specific ones, Nabisco, is now in session. Privilege. Mr. Benson, you're representing all bees of the world. Yeah, I'm kidding. Yes, Your Honor, we're ready to proceed. Mr. Montgomery, your opening statements, please. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my grandmother was a simple woman. Born on a farm, she believed it was a man's divine right to benefit from the bounty of nature God put before us. If we lived in a topsy-turvy world, Mr. Benson imagines, just take a look at what it would mean. I would have to negotiate with the silkworm for the elastic in my britches. Talking bee, how do we know this isn't some sort of holographic motion picture capture Hollywood wizardry? They could be using laser beams, robotics, ventriloquism, cloning, for all we know. They could be on steroids, Mr. Benson. Ladies and gentlemen, there is no trickery here. I'm just an ordinary bee. Honey's pretty important to me. It's important to all bees. We invented it. We make it. George B. B. George Washington Carver made the first honey peanut butter. Honey butter. We make it and we protect our lives with it. Unfortunately, there are some people in this room who think they can take it from us. Because we're little guys. I'm hoping that after all this is over, you'll see how. By taking our honey, you not only take everything we have, but everything we are.
I wish you dressed like that all the time. So nice.
Call your first witness.
So, Mr. Klaus Vanderhaden, it's a honey farm. It's a big company you have, I suppose. So,
I see you also own Honeyburn and Humrod.
Yes, they provide beekeepers for our farms.
Beekeeper?
I find that term very disturbing.
I don't imagine you employ any bee freeers, do you?
No, I couldn't hear you.
No, no. Bees don't free bees. You keep bees. Not only that, it seems you thought a bear would be an appropriate image for a jar of honey. They're very lovable creatures. Yogi Bear, Fozzie Bear, Build-A-Bear. You mean like this? Bears kill bees. How do you like his head crashing through your living room, biting into your couch, spitting out your throw pillows? Okay, that's enough. Take him away. So, Mr. Sting, thanks for being here. Your name intrigues me. Well, we heard it before. I was in a band called the Police. But you've never been a police officer, have you?
No, I haven't.
No, you haven't. So here we have yet another example of bee culture casually stolen by a human for nothing more than a prize about Sting. Sting? From the police? Really? Really? Oh, please. Have you ever been stung, Mr. Sting? Because I'm feeling a little stung, Sting. Or should I say, Mr. Gordon M. Summer? That's not his real name, you idiots.
Mr. Liotta, first belated congratulations on your Emmy win for the guest spot on ER in 2005. Thank you, thank you. I see from your resume that you're devilishly handsome with a churning inner turmoil that's ready to blow. I enjoy what I do. Is that a crime? Not yet, it isn't. But is this what it's come to for you? Exploiting tiny, helpless bees so you don't have to rehearse your part to learn your lines, sir. Watch your Benson, I can blow right now. This isn't a good fella. This is a bad fella. Why doesn't someone just step on this creep and we can all just go home? Order in this court. You're all faking it. Order. Order, I say. Say it. Mr. Liotta, please calm down. I think it was awfully nice of that bear to pitch in like that. I think the jury's on our side. Are we doing everything right? Legally? I'm a florist. Right, well, here's to a great team. To a great team. Well, hello, Ken. Hello. I didn't think you were coming. No, this is late. I tried to call, but the battery. I didn't want all this to go to waste, so I called Barry. Luckily, he was free. Oh, that was lucky. There's a little left. I can eat it up. Yeah, eat it up. Sure. Whatever. So I hear you're quite a tennis player. I'm not much for the game myself. The ball's a little grabby. That's where I usually sit. Right there, Ken. Barry was looking at your resume, and he agreed with me that eating with chopsticks isn't really a special skill. You don't think I still see what you're doing? I don't know how hard it is to find the right job. We have that in common, do we? Bees have 100% employment, but we do jobs like taking the crud out. This is what I was thinking about doing. Ken, borrow your razor for his fuss. I hope that was all right. I'm going to go drain the old stinger. It's a penis. His stinger's a penis. I've been at this for 36 minutes, and somehow I'm not dead yet. Yeah, you do that. Look at that. You know, I've just about had it with your little mind games. What's that? Italian Vogue. Mamma mia, that's a lot of pages, a lot of ads. Remember when Van said, why is your life more valuable than mine? Funny. I just can't seem to recall that. I think something stinks in here. Love the smell of flowers. How do you like the smell of flames? Not as much. Water bug not taking sides. Ken, wear a chapstick hat. This is pathetic. I got issues. Well, well, well. A royal flush. You're bluffing, am I? Surf's up, dude. Poo water. That bowl is gnarly, except for those dirty yellow rings. Kenneth, what are you doing? You know, I don't even like honey. I don't need it. We need to talk. He's just a little bee. He happens to be the nicest bee I've ever met in a long time. Long time? What are you talking about? Are there other bugs in your life? No, but there are other things bugging me in my life, and you're one of them. Fine. Talking bees, no yogurt night. My nerves are fried from riding on this emotional roller coaster. Goodbye, Ken. And for your information, I prefer sugar-free artificial sweeteners made by man. I'm sorry about all that. I know it's got an aftertaste. I like it. I always felt like there was some kind of a barrier between Ken and me. I wouldn't overcome it. Oh, well. Are you okay for the trial? I believe Mr. Montgomery is out of ideas. We'd like to call Mr. Barry Benson B to the stand. Good idea. You can really see why he's considered one of the best lawyers. Yeah. Layton, you gotta weave some magic with this jury or it's gonna be all over. Don't worry. The only thing I have to do is turn the jury around just to remind them what they don't like about bees. You got the tweezers? Are you allergic? Only losing, son, only losing. Mr. Benson B, I'll ask you what I like to think we all like to know. What is exactly your relationship to that woman? We're friends. Good friends, yes. How good? Are you? Do you live together? Wait a minute. Are you little her little bed bug? I've seen a little bee documentary or two, from what I understand. Doesn't your queen give birth to all the bee children? Yeah, but so those aren't your real parents. Oh, Barry, yes, they are. Hold me back. Are you an illegitimate bee, Archie Benson? He's denouncing bees. Don't y'all date your cousins? Objection. I'm gonna pick cushion this guy. Adam, don't. It's what he wants. Oh, I'm hit. Oh, Lordy, I'm hit. Order, order. The venom. The venom is coursing through my veins. I've been felled by a winged beast of destruction. You see? You can't treat them like equals. They're striped savages. They're like Native Americans. Native Bearicans. Sting is the only thing they know. It's their way. Adam, stay with me. I can't feel with my legs. One angel of mercy will come forward and suck the poison from my heated buttocks. I'll have order in this court. Order. Order, please. The case of honeybees versus the human race took a pointed turn against the bees yesterday. One of their legal team stung Leighton T. Montgomery. Hey, buddy. Hey. Is there much pain? Yeah. I blew the whole case, didn't I? Doesn't matter. What matters is you're alive. You could have died. You should have died. You're a fucking bee. You stunned someone. You should have died. That's what it is. I'd be better off dead. Look at me. They got it from the cafeteria downstairs in a tuna sandwich. Look, there's a little celery still on it. What was it like to sting someone? I can't explain it. It was all adrenaline and ecstasy. All right. You think it was a trap? Of course. I'm sorry. I flew us right into this. What are you thinking? Look at us. We're just a couple of bugs in this world. What will the humans do to this if they win? I don't know. I hear they put the roaches in motels. That doesn't sound so bad. They die in those motels. They die. I remember in second grade when I lived with my mom. She had cockroaches. I remember I saw a white roach once. It was a really weird experience. I think the cockroach is my spirit animal.
makes sense for someone as disgusting and just completely worthless as I am to have a cockroach as a spirit animal. Well, maybe that day I saw my future scurrying around on the ground eating crumbs. Anyway, let's get back to the script. I'm dying. This is, if you're still here in this video, I'm sorry. Adam, they check in, but they don't check out. Oh my, could you get to Hotel California for roaches? Could you get a nurse to close that window? Why, the smoke? Bees don't smoke, right? Bees don't smoke. Bees don't smoke, but the bees are smoking. That's it. That's your case. It is. It's not over. Get dressed. I gotta go somewhere. Get back to the corn stall. Stall any way you can. And assume you've done step correctly. You're ready for the top. Mr. Flamin, yes? Yes, Your Honor. What is the rest of your team? Well, Your Honor, it's interesting. Bees are trained to fly haphazardly, and as a result, they don't make very good time. Actually, I heard a funny story about Your Honor. Have these ridiculous bugs taken up enough of the court's valuable time? How longer will we allow these absurd shenanigans to go on? They have presented no compelling evidence to support their charges against my clients who run legitimate businesses. I move for a complete dismissal of this entire case. Mr. Flamin, I'm afraid I'm going to have to consider Mr. Montgomery's motion. But you can't. We have a terrific case. Where's your proof? Where's the evidence? Show me the smoking gun. Hold it, Your Honor. You want a smoking gun? Here's your smoking gun. What is that? It's a bee smoker. What is this? This horrible silicone contraption? This couldn't hurt a fly, let alone a bee. Look what has happened to bees who've never been asked, smoking and non-smoking. Is this what nature intended for us? To be forcibly addicted to smoke machines and man-made wooden slot work camps? Living out our lives as honey slaves to the white man? What are we going to do? He's playing the species card. Oh, that's so bad. Ladies and gentlemen, please free these bees. Free the 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 bees. The court finds in favor of the bees. Vanessa, we won. I knew you could do it. High five. Sorry, high for five. Okay, you know what this means? All the honey will finally belong to the bees. Now we won't have to work so hard all the time. This is an unholy pervasion of the balance of nature, Benson. You'll regret this. Barry, how much honey is out there? All right, one at a time. Barry, who are you wearing? My sweater is Ralph Lauren, and I have no pants. What if Montgomery's right? What if you mean? We've been living the bee way a long time, 27 million years. Congratulations on your victory. Only demand is seven. First, we'll demand a complete shutdown of all bee work camps. Burke, the bee holocaust is over. Then we want the honey that was ours to begin with, every last drop. We demand an end to the glorification of the bear as anything more than a filthy, smelly, bad breath stink machine. We're all aware of what they do in the woods. With my signal, take him out. He'll have nauseous for a few hours, and then he'll be fine. We'll no longer have to tolerate bee-negative nicknames. But it's just a prank about stage name, unnecessary inclusion of honey and bogus health products, and la-di-da human tea time snack garnishments. Can't breathe. Bring it in, boys. Hold it right there. Good. Tap it. Mr. Boswell, we've passed three cups, and there's gallons more incoming. I think we need to shut down. Shut down. We've never shut down. Shut down honey production. Stop making honey. Turn your key, sir. What do we do? Now. Cannonball. We're shutting down honey production. Mission abort. Aborting pollination and nectar detail. Returning to base. Adam, you wouldn't believe how much honey was out there. Oh, yeah? What's going on? Where is everybody? Are they celebrating? They're home. They don't know what to do. Laying out, sleeping in, and her drunk Carl was on his way to San Antonio with a cricket. Please forget our honey bag. Sometimes I think, what if humans liked our honey? Who wouldn't? It's the greatest thing in the world. I was excited to be part of making it. This is my new desk. This is my new job. I wanted to do it really well. And now I can. I don't understand why they're not happy. I thought their lives would be better. They're doing nothing. It's amazing. Honey really changes people. You don't have any idea what's going on, do you? What do you want to show me? This. What happened here? This is the half of it. Oh, no. Oh, my. They're all wilting. Doesn't look very good, does it? No. And who saw falses? You think that is? You know, I'm going to guess bees. Bees? Specifically me bees. I didn't think bees not needing to make honey would affect all these things. It's not just flowers. Fruit, vegetables, they all need bees. That's our whole SAT test right there. Take away produce, that affects the entire animal kingdom, and then, of course, the human species. So if there's no pollination, it could all just go south here, couldn't it? I know this is partly my fault. How about a suicide pact? How do we do it? I'll sting you, you just step on me, that just kills you twice. Right, right. Listen, Mary, sorry, but I gotta get going. I had to open up my mouth and talk. Vanessa, why are you leaving? Where are you going? To the final tournament of Roses Parade in Pasadena. They moved this weekend because all the flowers are dying. It's the last chance I'll ever get to see it. Vanessa, I just want to say I'm sorry. I never meant it to turn out like this. I know. Me neither. Tournament of Roses. Roses can't do sports. Wait a minute. Roses. 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 Vanessa. Roses. Berry. Roses. Flowers. Yes, they are. Flowers. Bees. Pollination. I know. That's why it's the last parade. Maybe not. Could you ask him to slow it down? Could you slow it down? Barry, I made a huge mistake. This is a total disaster. All my fault. Yeah, it kind of is. I've ruined the planet. I wanted to help you with the flowers, not by made it worse.
Actually, it's completely closed down. I thought maybe you were remodeling. But I have another idea, and it's greater than my previous ideas combined. I don't want to hear it. All right, they have the roses. The roses have fallen. I know every bee, plant, and flower bought in this park. All you gotta do is get what they got back here with what we got. Bees, park, pollen, flowers, repollination across the nation. Turn the roses, Pasadena, California. They got nothing but flowers, floats of cotton candy, security wheel tight. But I have an idea. Vanessa Bloom FTD, official floor business. It's real. Sorry, ma'am. Nice brooch. Thank you. It was a gift. Once inside, we just picked the right floor. How about the princess and the pea? I could be the princess, and you could be the pea. You got it. Where should I sit? What are you? I believe I'm the pea. The pea goes under the mattresses. Not this fairy tale, sweetheart. I'm getting the Marshall. You do that, the whole parade is a fiasco. Let's see what this baby will do. Hey, what are you doing? And all we do is blend in with the traffic without arousing suspicion. Once at the airport, there's no stopping us. Stop. Security. You and the insect packed your float? Yes. Has it been in your possession the entire time? Would you remove your shoes? Remove your stinger. It's part of me. I know. Just having some fun. Enjoy your flight. And if we're lucky, we'll have just enough pollen to do the job. Can you believe how lucky you are? We have just enough pollen to do the job. I think this is going to work. It's going to work. Attention passengers, this is Captain Scott. We have a bit of bad weather in New York. Looks like we'll experience a couple flowers delay. There are these cut flowers with no water in them. Never make it. I gotta get up there and talk to them. Be careful. Can I get help with the Skyball magazine? I'd like to order the talking inflatable nose and ear hair trimmer. Captain, I'm in a real situation. What'd you say? No, nothing. B, don't freak out. My entire species, what are you doing? Wait a minute. I'm an attorney. Who's an attorney? Attorney. Don't move. Oh, Barry. Good afternoon, passengers. This is your captain. Would Miss Vanessa Bloom 224B please report to the cockpit? And please hurry. What happened here? There was a dustbuster, a toupee, and a life raft exploded. One's bald, one's in a boat. They're both unconscious. Is that another bee joke? No. No one's flying the plane. It's JFK Control Tower, flight 356. What's your situation? This is Vanessa Bloom. I'm a florist from New York. Where's the pilot? He's unconscious, and so is the co-pilot. Not good. Does anyone on board have any flight experience? As a matter of fact, there is. Who's that? Barry Benson, from the honey trial. Oh, great. Vanessa, this is nothing more than a big metal bee. It's got giant wings, huge engines. I can't fly a plane. Why not? Isn't John Travolta a pilot? Yes. How hard could it be? Wait, Barry, we're headed into some lighting. This is Bob Bundle. We have some late-breaking news from JFK Airport, where a suspenseful scene is developing. Barry Benson, fresh from his legal victory, that Barry, is attempting to land a plane loaded with people, flowers, and an incapacitated flight crew. Flowers? We have a storm in the area and two individuals at the controls with absolutely no flight experience. Just a minute. There's a bee on that plane. I'm quite familiar with Mr. Benson and his no-account compadres. They've done enough damage. But isn't he your only hope? Technically, a bee shouldn't be able to fly at all. Their wings are too small. Haven't we heard this a million times? I know I have. The surface area of the wings and the body mass make no sense. Get us up there. Got it. Stand by. We're going to live. The way we work may be a mystery to you. Making honey takes a lot of bees doing a lot of small jobs. But let me tell you about a small job. If you do it well, it makes a big difference. More than we realize to us. For everyone. That's why I want to get bees back to work together. That's a bee way. We're not made of jello, but get behind a fellow. Black and yellow. Hello. Left, right, down, hover. Hover. Forget hover. This isn't so hard. Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Barry, what happened? Wait, I think we were on autopilot the whole time. That may have been helping me, and now we're not. So it turns out I cannot fly a plane. All of you, let's get behind this fellow. Move it out. Move it out. Our only chances. If I do what I do, you copy me with the wings of the plane. Don't have to yell. I'm not yelling. We're in a lot of trouble. It's very hard to concentrate with that panicky tone in your voice. It's not a tone. I'm panicking. I can't do this. But as to pull yourself together, you have to snap out of it. You 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 snap out of it. Hold on. Why? Come on. It's my turn. How's the plane flying? I don't know. Hello? That's the guy. Any flowers for a happy occasion in there at the pollen jocks? They do get behind a fellow. Black and yellow. Hello. All right. Let's drop this tin can on the blacktop. Where? I can't see anything. Can you? No, nothing. It's all cloudy. Come on, you gotta think bee, Barry. Thinking bee, thinking bee, thinking bee, thinking bee, thinking bee. Wait a minute. I think I'm feeling something. What? I don't know. It's strong, pulling me like a 27-million-year-old instinct. Bring the nose down. Thinking bee, thinking bee, thinking bee. What in the world is on the tarmac? Get some lights on that. Thinking bee, thinking bee, thinking bee. What is it? Aim for the flower. Okay. Out the engines, we're going in on bee power. Ready, boys? Affirmative. Good, good, easy. Now that's it. Land on that flower. Ready? Four of her. Spin around. Not that flower, the other one. Which one? That flower. Maybe the other flower. That's a fat guy in a flowered shirt. I mean, the giant pulsating flower made of millions of bees. Pull forward, nose down, tail up, rotating around.
This is insane, Barry. This is the only way I know how to fly. I could look at you, or is this plane flying in an insect-like pattern?
Get your nose in there. Don't be afraid. Smell it. Full reverse. Just drop it. Be a part of it. Aim from the center. Now drop it in, woman. Come on already. Barry, we did it. You taught me to fly. Yes, no high five.
Right. Barry, it worked. Did you see the giant flower?
What giant flower?
Where?
Of course I saw the flower. That was genius.
Thank you. We're not done yet. Listen, everyone. This runway is covered with the last pollen from the last flowers of anywhere on Earth. That means this is our last chance. We're the only ones who make honey, pollinate flowers, and dress like this. We're going to survive as species. This is our last moment. What do you say? Are we going to be bees or just Museum of Natural History keychains? We're bees. Keychain. And follow me.
Except keychain. Hold on, Barry, here. You've heard this.
Yeah, I'm a pollen jack. It's a perfect fit.
All I got to do are the sleeves.
Oh, yeah.
Answer, Barry. Bob, the bees are back.
If anybody needs to make a call, now's the time. I got a feeling we'll be working late tonight.
Here's your change. Have a great afternoon. Can I help us next?
Would you like some honey with this?
It is bee approved. Don't forget bees.
No cream cheese, Tommy, and I don't see a nickel.
Sometimes I just feel like a piece of meat. I had no idea.
Barry, I'm sorry. Have you got a moment?
Would you excuse me? My mosquito associate will help you.
Sorry I'm late.
He's a lawyer, too.
I was already a blood-sucking parasite.
All I need to go to the briefcase.
Have a great afternoon.
Barry, I just got this huge tulip order, and I can't get them anywhere.
No problem, Danny. Just leave it to me.
You're a lifesaver, Barry.
Can I help who's next?
All right, Scramble Jacks, it's time to fly.
Thank you, Barry.
That bee is living my life.
Let it go, Kenny.
When will this nightmare end?
Let it all go.
Yeah, the bee movie predicted Frozen.
Beautiful day to fly.
Sure is.
Between you and me, I was dying to get out of that office.
You've got to start thinking bee, my friend.
Thinking bee?
Me?
Hold it.
Listen, stop.
Oh, fuck.
Jesus Christ, it spooked me. I got to do a bee movie trance there.
Hold on. Let's just stop for a second. Hold it. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, everyone. Can we just stop here?
I'm not making a major life decision during a production number.
All right. Take that, everybody. Wrap it up, guys.
And virtually no rehearsal for that.
Thank you for watching. If you watch this video all the way through, good job. And please consider checking out my other videos. There are also things I'm going to go and die. Like and subscribe. You know, you just like and subscribe. Oh.